हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज चैप्टर 13 मोशन एंड टाइम फ्रॉम क्लास 7th. नाउ हियर यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मोशन एंड टाइम. सो इन द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न मोशन मीन्स व्हाट. नाउ सी हियर, इफ यू सी हियर द कार इज मूविंग कंटिन्यूअसली, हियर द पेंडुलम इज ऑल्सो मूविंग, एंड हियर a blue dot revolving around the red dot. Now see here, it is an example of earth revolving around the sun. Now what is the motion? So first we will understand the meaning of the motion. So motion is nothing but it is the change. Motion is the change in the position of an object with time. Now here object is car. So car is moving continuously, so with time the car position is also get changed. Means in 1 minute car can cover 1 kilometer distance, otherwise in 2 minutes car can cover more than 1 kilometer distance. In this way, in 3rd minute again car will cover more distance. So there is a change in the position of the car. There is a change in the position of the car with time. So if there is a change in the position of an object with time, then it is called as that object is in motion. Now there are the different types of motion, and which are those? Now if you see here, the car is moving along a straight line or straight road, so that it's called as rectilinear motion. If the motion is along the straight line, it is called as rectilinear motion. An example is motion of car on a straight road. Now another type of the motion is periodic motion, and here next type is circular motion. Now here the simple pendulum example you can take about for the periodic motion. So periodic motion means here if the pendulum moves from this point to this point, and continuously the movement pendulum is moving from this point to this point. So here the pendulum comes at the original position back after some time, after some period. So it requires to get the position back some period, and that is called as periodic motion here. So the object comes in its original position back after some period. Means if you see here, this motion is to and fro motion or back and forth motion. It is also called as periodic motion. Now circular motion. So earth revolving around the sun in a circular path. If you see this, this is a circular path. So here this motion is called as circular motion. Now next point is speed. So many times we heard the word speed, but what is the speed? The distance covered by an object in unit time is called as the speed of the object. In the previous example you have seen the car was moving along the straight road, so the car had covered some distance with time, in a time. For example, if in 5 minutes if car covered 5 kilometer distance, then that distance covered by an object in unit time is called as speed of the object. So how can we calculate the speed of the object? Here example is given. Suppose if a car covers a distance of 100 kilometers in 1 hour and a bus covers a distance of 50 kilometers in 1 hour, then the speed of car is more than the speed of the bus. So naturally we know this, when car covers distance 100 kilometers in 1 hour, if you see here, the distance covered by car and bus is different. By car it is covered 100 kilometers, and by bus it is covered 50 kilometers. But the time period to cover the distance is same. That is 1 hour, 1 hour. But time period is same, but distance covered is different. So we can easily say the car speed is higher than the, or more than the bus speed. So how can we calculate the speed? So here is the formula. Total distance covered upon time taken. Means here you have to write the distance covered, and here you have to write the time taken. And when you divide this covered distance by the time, you will get the speed of the car or speed of the bus. Now suppose another one line is given here, that is, since the speed of the most objects are not constant, the speed is average speed. So here it is given, speed of most objects are not constant, means if a car is running on a road, so sometimes car runs on a road with a high speed, sometimes its speed is slow, so that speed is not constant, so there the average speed can be calculated. Now uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So what is uniform motion and non-uniform motion? You can see here, if the speed of an object is constant, means not changing, constant means what? Not changing. If the speed of that object, may be car or a bus or any object you can take, so if the speed of that object is constant, it is called as uniform motion. And if the speed of the object keeps on changing, if the speed is not constant, if the continuously speed is changing, sometimes more, sometimes less, so that motion of the object is non-uniform. Suppose a car moving along a empty road, which is a straight road and there is no traffic, so there may be the car has constant speed, but if the car is running on a road which is very crowded, so there the speed gets changed, sometime it is more, sometime it is less, so that time we can say when the car is on crowded road, so that car motion is non-uniform. And when the car is on empty road, there we can say the car's motion is uniform motion, because maybe car is moving with the constant speed, means the speed will not get changed. But if there is a crowd, driver has to change the speed. If you see in this picture, these are the different type of instruments which are used to measure the time. Now time is measured by using clocks or watches. Clocks and watches make use of periodic motion. Now here the pendulum is shown, and this is the wall clock, this is the table clock, watches, this one is also wall clock, digital clocks, and this is the watch. Now see here, all these type of instruments shows the time. We can measure the time with the help of this. So these watches and clocks make use of periodic motion, means after some period the clock shows the same time. Now simple pendulum. So simple pendulum means what? So simple pendulum, if you see this, this is the diagram of simple pendulum, so you can understand what is a simple pendulum. So here simple pendulum is nothing but this downside black color dot is that it is called as bob. So this bob is a metallic ball, and this bob is tied with the thread. So this is the thread, and this black color dot it is nothing but it is a bob which is made by the metallic ball. Simple pendulum has some metallic bob suspended from a stand by a thread. So this one is stand, and this stand, to the stand this bob is attached with the help of thread. So this bob and this thread and this stand togetherly called as simple pendulum. If the bob is taken to one side and released, it moves to and fro. The to and fro motion of the simple pendulum is called periodic motion or oscillatory motion. Now see here, here we can see this bob is continuously moving from A point to O point and O to B. Then again from B to O it comes, and in O to A it comes. So when we take bob to the A side and when we release, then after releasing the bob goes to A to O, O to B, and again from B it comes back to the O. So this bob is continuously moving to and fro, means back and forth. So this motion is called as oscillatory motion, or periodic motion also you can say. Now, oscillation. So, what is the oscillation? When the bob moves from the mean position O to A and to B and back to O, it is called one oscillation. Now, here in the diagram you can see this is the mean position O, and when the bob moves from O to A, then it comes to the B and again it comes to the O. So, this is called as one oscillation. So, when bob moves, now see bob is at, otherwise we can simply say here, if we see now here A position is the extreme position, B is also extreme position and O is the mean position. Now see here, if you take the bob to the A side and if you release the bob, bob will go from A to O, O to B, then again it comes back B to O and O to A. So at that time we can say one oscillation is completed. So when bob moves from A to B and back to the A, then one oscillation is completed. That is called as one oscillation. So when the bob moves from one extreme position A to other extreme position B and back to A, it's called as one oscillation. So then if it moves from A to B, we cannot say one oscillation is completed. No. But when it moves from A to B and again it come back to the A, then we can say one oscillation is completed. And here the time taken by the pendulum to complete one oscillation is called as time period. So when the bob moves from A to B and again back to A, and how much time is required to complete this one oscillation, that is called as time period. Maybe few seconds are required, so that is called as time period. So what is time period? The time taken. Who has taken the time? Bob. Bob has taken, or pendulum. We can say simply pendulum. The time taken by the pendulum for what? To complete one oscillation is called as time period. Now this is the activity to calculate the time period, to measure the time period of a simple pendulum. So in this way you have to set all the apparatus, you have to take the simple pendulum and you have to release the simple pendulum from A to, from A position. So when it will go B and when it will come A, then you have to calculate one oscillation. So in this way you have to count the time for 20 oscillations. And how much time is required for 20 oscillations, you have to note down here. Means see here, if you start from here, now one oscillation, sorry, see here, one oscillation, two oscillation, 3, 4, 5. In this way you have to count up to 20 and then you have to check how much time is required to calculate this 20 oscillation. So every time you have to calculate for 20 oscillations and whatever time is required, you have to note down here. Now unit of time and speed. Simply we know that the unit of time means, what is the unit of time? Now here you are going to learn unit of speed also. Now the basic unit of time is second. The basic unit of time is second, which is denoted by small s. And larger unit of time are minutes, which is denoted by min. Hours, which is denoted by h. So minutes and hours are larger unit of times and smaller unit of time is second. And for the speed, basic unit of the speed is meter per second, which can be written in this way, meter per second. You have to remember both the letters are small, m also small and s also small. And the larger unit for the speed is kilometer per hour, km per hour. H. So these are the units of the speed and time. Basic units of time, basic units of speed, larger units of time and larger units of speed. Now in ancient period, or what are the devices used to measure the time at the ancient time? We know that. So here some pictures are shown. Some ancient time measuring devices are shown here. This is the sundials. water clocks and this is the sand clocks. So the sand clocks, water clocks and sundial, these are the devices which are used to measure the time in the ancient period. Sundial, water clock and sand clock. Measuring speed. Now, how can we measure the speed? The speed of an object can be measured if we know the distance covered by the object and the time taken. So, how can we measure the speed? To calculate the speed of any vehicle, we should know how much distance covered by the object and what time is required. Suppose a car. If car covers 100 kilometers in 2 hours, then the speed of the car is. So, like this questions will appear in the exam. So, you have to write the form, you have to write given data first. Distance covered is equal to 100 kilometer, time taken 2 hour, and then you have to write the formula. So there are some marks for the formula writing also. So speed is equal to distance upon time. So what is the distance? 100, and time 2 hour. So 100 upon 2, when you divide this 100 by 2, you will get the answer 50. And we know the unit of the speed, larger unit of the speed is kilometer per hour. So you have to write unit also, otherwise your marks will get deducted from the answer sheet. Now, if we know speed of the car and time also, but if in the problem distance is asked, so how can we write? So the distance formula is equal to speed into time. So whatever speed is given into time, we can get the distance. So speed is given 50 and time is given 2 hour. So your distance will be 50 into 2, 100 kilometer. So kilometer is the unit of the distance. Understood? So here, if we know distance covered by the car and the speed, we can find time also. So what is the time formula? Distance upon speed. If distance is given 100 kilometer and speed is given 50, then 100 divided by 50, you get the answer 2 hour. It is the time. So in the example, if you know the formula of speed is equal to distance upon time, you can calculate for the distance also, for time also, and for speed also. Means from this one formula, you can make another two formulae also about distance and time. So in this way, you have to practice for this example without forgetting the units. Now here you can see this one is the speedometer and this one is the speedometer and odometer. So these two are present in the vehicles. Now see a speedometer. What is the speedometer's use? What is the speedometer? It is a device which measures the speed of the vehicle in kilometer per hour. Every vehicle has speedometer and odometer. You can check if you have a bike, you can check whether the speedometer is given and odometer is given. In the car also, both are given there. So speedometer, the meaning of the speedometer is hidden in the name itself. Speed means it measures speed of the vehicle, but in which unit? In the kilometer per hour. And odometer, what is the use of this device? So odometer is the device which measures distance covered by the vehicle. So this odometer tells how much distance the vehicles traveled. So here speedometer and the odometer, this is combined. In some vehicle, both are in combined form, but in some vehicle, these are the separate also. So in short, odometer device used to measure the distance covered by the vehicle. The last point of the lesson is distance time graph. So here you can see on the graph paper, on the y-axis, distance is shown, on x-axis, time is shown. And now see here, the information is given in the table, and if you plot a graph for this given information, you can get the straight line. So when you will get the straight line, from this you can easily understand the if the distance time graph is in straight line, then the moving object is in constant speed. So this straight line shows the object was moving with a constant speed, means the speed was not changed. But if this line, if it is not straight, if it is curved, then we can say the speed of the object was changing. Okay, so this is the distance time graph traveled by a car and time means see here in 1 minute the car covered 1 kilometer distance. In 2 minute car covered 2 kilometer distance. In 3 minutes car covered 3 kilometer distance. In 4 minute car covered 4 kilometer distance. Means in each and every minute car has covered 1 kilometer distance. Means 1 kilometer in 1 minute. 1 kilometer in 1 minute. In this way the car's speed was constant. So this is the straight line which shows the car was moving in a constant speed. Means the speed was not changed.